this time for the continuing story of Texas.
You and Barrett had come back from visiting Buddy and wanted to call him again, that's all.
Barrett stopped at the bunkhouse and I walked on up and came in the front door. What are you doing?
Taking out this flashlight. I'm going to go for a walk and I wanted to make sure that the batteries were working.
Well, there's a lot of power left in that. Must be new batteries. Why don't you use the big battery light that's out on the back porch? It's a lot more powerful than that one.
Oh, thanks. I'll do that.
Steve watching TV?
No, he's already in bed. He just tried to do too much today. He's worn out. Kate, did you ever tell Barrett that his father's personal papers were down in the storm cellar?
No, I don't think I have mentioned them to him.
Are you sure?
Positive. Why do you ask?
Tell me she's going outside.
Sense of me.
She's taking off. But this don't make any sense. Where could she have gone?
I'll check with the guys in the band. Get one of them safe.
Come back so you find out anything, okay?
Billy Joe, calm down, okay? Now, she's probably just out getting some air. You know how jumpy she gets before a show?
Jeb, she hasn't been jumpy since she came to New York. In fact, she's been feeling great. Where could she go?
Don't bother to look around. You're never going to see this again.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
I'm not sure why I never discussed Mike's personal papers with
Why did you put those papers down there, Kate?
Well, it must have been soon after he left for Vietnam on his second tour of duty. Mike came out to the ranch one weekend and put a lot of stuff down there.
Has anyone been down there since?
I don't think anyone's been down there but you. And Jeb, when he put on the new cellar doors. Why are you so interested in Mike's personal papers?
Oh, I was just wondering, that's all.
Well, if you'll check on Steve for me, I'm going to go take that walk.
Don't stay away too long.
What do you mean? I mean, what do you think Mom's hiding from?
Maybe I shouldn't even have said that much.
Why not? Vivian, what is it you're trying to say?
It's just
what?
That night that Mr. Shaw was murdered, Mrs. Wheeler and I went over to the co-op. She made me wait in the parking lot. She went in and got you.
Vivian, I know all that, but what is it that's bothering you?
It's just a feeling that I have that something happened in there before I got there. Like, Mrs. Wheeler, something she doesn't want to tell me about.
Vivian, what could have happened? I killed Chris Shaw long before Mom got there. I was unconscious when she came in.
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Vivian, I mean, you just got here.
I'm afraid so. Only one visitor at a time and only 5 minutes. Well, don't go on my account, Vivian. I can come back later.
No. I have to get back to the house. Mrs. Wheeler might need me for something.
It's good to see you, son. Vivian certainly seemed jumpy. Yourself a very nice setup, haven't you?
May I ask why you've come back here at this hour?
Do I have to have a reason to see an old friend?
I'm surprised to see you at all after the other day.
That's why I've come by. I'd like to know exactly how much you've told anybody about what you saw the other night.
You knew Alex had had a stroke, didn't you, Peter?
Did I?
I saw you coming out of his office. You made certain that I didn't go in there.
Suppose I did.
Peter, I want to know what happened in that office.
Please, now don't go worrying over that. It's no concern of yours.
It is my concern. Alex Wheeler's been very good to me. He was helping me try to patch up my marriage with Dennis. He let me stay in this suite. If you did anything to hurt him...
What? That sounded like a threat, Paige. You don't want to threaten me. After everything we've shared. Do you?
What we had is over now.
Is it?
Yes.
After what you did to me? You must be joking.
You're very pretty when you're upset. You always were.
The only feeling I have for you now, Peter, is loathing.
I think I could change that.
Don't touch me again.
Or what?
Here.
I'll leave when I'm ready.
Why did you come here? Why did you come back to Houston?
Business.
Oh, great. If it has anything to do with Jim Lawrence, it's probably dangerous.
Hey, it's my favorite kind.
Peter, did you do anything to cause Alex's stroke?
Nothing.
Oh, Peter, I don't believe you.
Paige, you're being silly. People don't cause strokes. If you don't believe me, it's no problem.
I could make it yours.
No, I wouldn't advise that. As a matter of fact, I'd advise you to forget that you ever saw me here. But you can't. Can you?
Vivian certainly seems very concerned about you.
Yeah, well, she's really been terrific, Dad.
On the night of the murder, when you drove back to Iris's after leaving Chris Shaw's office, I suppose Vivian must have been very concerned about you then, too.
She was.
You know, you never did tell me exactly what happened that night.
Yeah, I did, Dad. I was drunk. I killed Chris Shaw. I drove back to Mom's. What more is there to tell?
You must have had difficulty driving.
Why?
Well, you were apparently inebriated.
But, Dad, I don't really remember that much about that night.
Well, driving in that state, you were lucky you weren't killed.
I guess I was.
Was Vivian there when you told Iris about killing Chris Shaw?
No, Dad, she was in her room.
And then Iris must have told her later.
Yeah, I guess she did.
You don't seem too sure about that.
Well, Dad, I'm not that sure. I mean, I was drunk.
But you clearly remember killing Chris Shaw.
Well,
Dennis, you either remember killing the man or you don't.
I do remember, Dad. I killed him.
What did you tell the police?
The truth. That I fought with Chris Shaw and that I killed him. Look, Dad, if it's just the same to you, I just assume we didn't go over all this, all right?
I just want to get the facts straight.
Yeah.
Papers haven't made things very clear. I wanted to ask you about this earlier, but I thought...
Look, Dad, I killed Chris Shaw. Can we just leave it at that and forget it?
Forgive me. I'm a journalist, so I ask a lot of questions. I also happen to love you very much. And I care very deeply what happens to you.
I know you.
I don't want to see you spend the rest of your life in prison.
I'm afraid that's up to Stryker in the courts now.
I don't understand. It doesn't make any sense. I mean, she would just up and take off like that. Where would she go?
Are you keeping something from me?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the drugs and all that stuff that Elena was taking back in Houston.
Oh, come on, Jim.
Wait a minute, man. I thought you said she was awful.
She was!
Are you sure?
I didn't give her any pills.
Yeah, but she might be getting them someplace else or something. That's what I gotta find out.
As far as I know, Elena wasn't taking nothing. Eh? You should know that better than me. You were with her all the time.
All I'm saying is the guys in the band, maybe somebody's feeding her some kind of stuff. That we
hey, you guys, where's Elena? Isn't it about time for a show to start?
We don't know where Elena is. She's gone somewhere.
She's gone?
What's the news, Hank? Did any of the guys in the band see Elena?
Well, I talked to them all. The only one seen her is Al.
Where did he see her?
He says she left the club.
Was she by herself?
No, Al says she left with some guy.
But then he could get a look at the guy.
Yeah, he said just an average-looking sort of guy. Blonde.
asleep.
Is Jenny upstairs with him?
No, she went for a walk.
At this time of night?
Well, she was restless. I can understand.
I don't understand it at all. Why should she be restless?
She's been cooped up in this house for days, taking care of Steve. She missed her walk. Mm-hmm. You know, Jenny told me that you had an argument with Rena.
That girl is causing more trouble.
Justin's the one that's causing the trouble. He's the one you should be mad at.
I'm mad at both of them.
That won't help the situation any.
I know. Oh, I promised Steve that I'd fix this for him tonight. What the hell is this doing here?
Well, Jenny left it there. She was going to take it with her, but I talked her into taking the big battery light out on the back porch.
Strange feeling, and you're the only one I can talk to about it.
What kind of feeling?
You and Barrett had that argument, and you mentioned about the geological survey.
Oh, Jenny, I'm sorry about that.
No. But Rena, do you remember what he said to you? He asked you what you were doing in the cellar going through his father's personal papers.
Yes, I do remember him saying that. Why, Jenny?
Because there's no way that Barrett could know that those papers were down there.
Well, he might have seen them years ago.
No, Kate told me that Mike put the papers down after Barrett had left for Vietnam. And no one's told him that they were down there.
What are you trying to say?
Remember the flashlight I found? I went down to the cellar tonight and I found it there. I'm not the only one who's been down in that cellar recently. I think that Barrett's been down there, too.
What's wrong with Barrett going down there?
Because he told me he hadn't. Why would he lie to me?
I don't know, Jenny. Did they replace the doors to the cellar after you got trapped there?
Yes.
Well, then that's what happened. Barrett left the flashlight down there when he was putting the new doors on.
Jeff replaced the doors.
Well, then he left it when he was checking it out.
Even so, the survey wasn't there then. I'd already given it to you.
Jenny, you don't mean it.
Hey, Jenny. I'm surprised to see you.
Max, I was just out taking a walk. I've got to be going home now.
Oh, don't go yet, Jenny. Why don't you stay and have some coffee and cake with us?
With me. I saw you driving out of the parking lot. If this is your idea of a joke, let me remind you that Alex is lying in that room near death.
Let me see. It was raining, and I wasn't in the best of emotional states.
But it's difficult to miss that white car of yours, especially with Dennis slumped over in the front seat. And just what do you intend to do with this information?
That depends on you, Iris.
Oh, let me warn you, Paige. Not to play your cards too quickly.
Dennis told me that he was unconscious when you arrived.
And?
And I don't believe that Dennis is capable of killing any man. No matter what kind of But you think I am, is that it?
Yes. Yes, I do. I think you killed Chris Shaw, and Dennis is covering for you.
That's preposterous. The most preposterous accusation I have ever heard.
Is it? Well, you didn't think it was preposterous when the police thought that I killed Chris. And you certainly had as much or more to gain by Chris's death as I did. And you're very ruthless, Iris.
I don't know what you think you have to gain.
All I want to gain is seeing Dennis set free.
Well, if you want Dennis set free, you will not mention what you have just said to anyone, particularly the police.
Oh, you can drop the bullying act, Iris. It won't work.
You don't know the whole story, Paige.
Well, why don't you tell it to me? That's why I came here.
I can't.
Well, then maybe the police can convince you, Iris. I'm sure that they'll be very interested in this information.
I'm telling you, Paige. If you want Dennis set free, you will not repeat what you have just said to anyone.
Upset him?
Elliot, there's something I have to tell you.
What?
The night Chris Shaw was murdered.
Well, I've just been over all that with Dennis. It's not easy for him to talk about it right now.
I know it isn't.
His not remembering anything clearly doesn't help either.
Elliot, he remembers more than he's telling you. I don't know if I should be telling you this, Elliot.
Telling him what?
Well, Dennis doesn't want anyone to know.
Know what, for heaven's sake, Paige? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the fact that Iris was there.
Iris was where?
In Chris Shaw's office. The night that he was murdered. When I went to get the film, I saw her car pulling out of the parking lot.
That can't be.
I saw it very clearly, Elliot. There's no mistaking that white car of hers. And even though it was raining, I could distinctly see Dennis in the front seat, unconscious.
Dennis was with her?
Yes. That's what I told him today that I knew.
Dennis admitted that Iris was there that night?
Yes, he did.
And why hasn't he told this to anyone before? Why didn't he tell the police?
He doesn't want her involved in the case.
Well, why not? If she can shed some light on the subject.
Well, I guess he was afraid that she could be tried as an accessory to murder.
Anything that could clear Dennis should be told to the police right away.
I agree, Elliot. That's why I went to see Iris immediately after I left him.
Well, what did she say to you?
She told me that I shouldn't repeat anything I said to anyone, not even Stryker, that it would only make things worse for Dennis.
How could anything be worse for Dennis? He's pleading guilty to a crime I'm certain he didn't commit.
Dennis isn't capable of murdering anyone.
Stryker Bellman tells me that the district attorney is pressing for a charge of first-degree murder.
Oh, my God, Elliot. Elliot, I know Iris is trying to hide something, but I don't know how to find out what it is.
It just doesn't make any sense. My sister wouldn't walk off just like that with some strange guy.
Well, Hank says she did.
I know what Hank said. She still, it doesn't make sense. She wouldn't do it.
I talked to the guys in the family again. Just make sure no one else had seen her.
What'd they say?
One more seen her was out.
And he said that he left, that she left with some blonde guy.
Right. An average guy. Oh, Al says that he thought of the guy had a tattoo on his wrist.
Hey, wait a minute. What did you say?
Al says he got a tattoo right here.
What kind of tattoo?
It was sort of a sea serpent, sort of green.
Well, was this a young guy about our age?
Al didn't say why.
Hey, Ricky, you think you know this guy? There was this guy that Elena met at the coop, a sailor. He had a tattoo like that on his right hand. But that's the guy that was giving her the drugs.
What drugs?
While you were out of town, Elena got herself in some trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Her nerves. And she met this guy, this skip guy, this sailor guy. She met him at the coop, and he gave her some drugs to calm it. Oh, man. I don't know why I didn't stay with her. I should have been with her. I should have. That's what she was talking about.
What's the matter, Tim?
told me that that this guy had the sailor and some of his friends took her one day and drugged her and dragged her off and asked her some questions. I thought she was making it up because we caught her on the drugs and stuff, you know. Where did this happen? This happened in Houston. This guy's got her. Somewhere, someplace around here. Just as long as it takes for me to get what I want. What's the matter with Ginny?
Ginny and Barrett had a few problems.
Barrett told me that you had an argument with him.
Yes, I did. Did he tell you that I started it?
Did you?
No. I went to the Marshall Ranch and he just started arguing with me.
Well, he's as angry as me about this oil business. I mean, the idea of those oil rigs all over our land.
I've already argued about this with Barrett. I'm not going to argue with you too, Max. Now, you're both entitled to your own opinions, but I'm entitled to mine, too. Now, let's just drop it, okay? When you were saying our land, you were talking about you and Barrett, weren't you?
Yes, I suppose so.
You still think of me as an intruder, don't you?
No, Rena, it's just...
Just that... what?
It's just that you don't understand. This ranch land means to us.
Did your mother understand what it meant to your father?
Hello, Mr. Carrington. How are you?
Hello, Vivian. You planning a trip?
No, I'm just getting some of Mrs. Wheeler's things together. Take Mrs. Wheeler, and you know, I think she'd do just about anything for me, too.
I can believe that. Iris can be very loyal.
She sure can.
It's admirable the way she sticks by her friends, especially when they're in trouble.
Yes, sir.
Of course, there are times when that kind of loyalty can get you into trouble. Gets Mrs. Wheeler into trouble from time to time.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Iris will be very upset if Dennis is sent to prison, won't she?
Yeah, she sure would be, Mr. Carrington. I'm not sure even you can imagine how upset she'd be. I don't even think I'd want to be around if that happened.
Mrs. Wheeler would go to any length to keep Dennis from going to jail, wouldn't she?
Oh, yes, I guess Mrs. Wheeler would.
What were you going to say, Vivian?
I was just going to say, Mrs. Wheeler would do a lot.
You were going to say that she would stop at nothing, weren't you?
I don't think we should be having this conversation, Mr. Carrington.
Vivian. I want you to tell me what Mrs. Wheeler is hiding. Did you have a nice walk?
Yes, I did.
What are you doing with my flashlight?
I found it in the cellar.
When?
Tonight. Hasn't been down there very long, though, because the batteries are new. When were you in the storm cellar, Barrett? A lot of difference to me. I want to know when you were in that storm cellar and what you were doing there.
I went down to get the strawberry preserves. We talked about that.
You told me that you opened the door and looked around. You said you were afraid to go down those stairs because the boards were rotten.
Jenny,
you said you hadn't been down there.
You're mistaken, as usual. Was in Chris Shaw's office the night he was murdered.
Who told you that?
Doesn't matter who told me. The point is, I know it's true. It is true, isn't it, Vivian?
Yes, sir. We drove over there because Mrs. Wheeler was worried sick about Dennis.
You were there, too.
But I didn't go in the office. She had me wait in the car.
Why did Iris go in there? I mean, how did she know Dennis was there?
Because Dennis had been carrying on earlier that afternoon about Mr. Shaw, and then when she tried to get a hold of him at his apartment later that night, he didn't answer his phone, and she got really worried, so she figured he might be at the co-op.
So she went into the office alone. Why did she make you wait outside in the car?
I don't know.
Did Iris ever tell you what happened when she went into the office?
No, she didn't.
Was Chris Shaw already dead by the time you got there?
I don't know.
Was Dennis unconscious?
I'm not sure.
Vivian, I'm sorry to have to put you through this. And I have to ask you these questions. I know that you feel that you're betraying Mrs. Wheeler in some way, but believe me, it's the only way we can help Dennis. Now, I have to know what Iris found when she went in that office.
I told you, Mr. Carrington, I don't know. You ought to ask Mrs. Wheeler.
Well, I've spoken to her already. She didn't tell me the true thing, so I doubt she would know. Why didn't Iris tell the police that the two of you were there?
Because Dennis asked her not to. He didn't want her to get involved in it.
Doesn't Dennis understand that she is involved? You both are. If Iris knows anything,
I know, Mrs.
help
Wheeler,
Dennis.
And if she thought she could help Dennis by going to the police, she would have gone to the police immediately.
Well, I hope you're right, Vivian. Because Dennis has no recollection of killing that man. And if Iris had any idea why, any idea at all, then it would have been criminal of her not to tell the police.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to try and clear Dennis. That's what I'm going to do.
Was she a city girl like I am?
No, she wasn't a city girl. She grew up on a farm.
But did she like living out here on the ranch?
She never told me she didn't like it.
that she never understood your father's love of the land.
Maybe that's something only men can understand.
Kate feels the same way as you do, and she's a woman.
Kate's an exception.
Did your mother ever want a different kind of life? Let's say, away from the ranch?
No. We were happy. We had enough food to eat. My mother could sew, so we always had warm clothes to wear. Once, she knitted me this red flannel shirt. I loved that shirt. I wore it till it all but fell apart.
You really did love your mother, didn't you?
Love your mother, don't you, despite all the differences?
Oh, Max. Deep down inside, I love her as much as I love my daddy. Maybe even more.
Then you have to tell her. You have to find some way to tell her that, honey, because she needs to hear something like that from you.
You never talk about your mother. Because you feel guilty that you never told her how much you love her.
Yeah, I guess that's part of it.
Honey, it's okay. I can wait to hear the rest of it until you're ready to tell me.
Turn in.
You know, I wonder if I should call the house to see if Jenny got back all right.
Nah, if she hadn't been home by now, they'd have been on the phone already.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Listen, don't worry about Jenny and Barrett. They'll be just fine.
Geological survey.
After I got back from my trip, I went down to check things out.
That survey was not there after you got back from your trip. You must have gone down before you left.
Well, you're wrong.
Oh, no, Barrett. I am not wrong.
I suppose you've been listening to your little brother again, still trying to cause trouble for us.
Unless you have a reason to hide something, I don't see any reason you can't give me an honest answer to my question.
I'm not going to stand here and be subjected to the third degree. You're my wife. Or had you forgotten? You're supposed to love me, to care for
me. I've tried, but you're making it impossible. Something's happening to you, and I don't understand it. And what's more, I don't like it.
I think you owe me an apology.
I will apologize to you when I find out that I'm wrong, and I don't think I am wrong. I want answers.
All right. You obviously got some theory. What is it?
You ever went on any trip. I think you stayed here and waited until I went down in that cellar and locked me in. Did you lock me in that storm cellar, Barrett? Did you?
See Elena and this Skip guy leave the place, didn't he?
Yeah, he did, Hope, but all he remembers is him going out the door and disappearing around the corner. So I went out and I tried to talk to a few people on the street.
Any luck?
Nothing.
Did Al notice anything about Elena? Was she scared?
No, the only thing he noticed was this tattoo.
Hey, Ricky! Isn't this the good luck bracelet you gave Elena for good luck just before she did the demo tape?
Yeah, that's it. What about it?
Well, I may be wrong or something, but it looks like either Elena or somebody put it in the shape of an S.
Wait a minute, S for Skip.
What?
That's what Elena's trying to leave us a message, tell us what happened to her. This guy Skip has got her somewhere.
Where are you going?
If it's late, I'm turning in. I think you should do the same. You got a big day ahead of you.
Ricky was coming to the show.
I'm afraid that's one performance you're just gonna have to miss.
He was a policeman, you know. He'll find me.
I don't think so.
He knows your name.
Oh, didn't I tell you? My name's not Skip. It's Joe Foster.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
Cleaning up in the kitchen.
Does it hurt? Are you okay?
Yeah, fine. Shouldn't you be getting ready for school? It's late.
There's no school today because of the teacher's meeting. I was going to go over to Buddy's to play, but...
But what?
I think I'll stay here with you.
Well, you don't have to do that, Stephen.
Well, you always stay with me when I'm sick.
Well, that is very sweet of you to be concerned, but I'll be just fine. Now, why don't you go over to Buddy's and I'll see you at lunchtime, okay?
Feeling. You slept in the guest room last night. You haven't said a word to me all morning. Ginny, I said I was sorry.
It's not enough, Barrett. Not anymore.
Mean to hit.
Don't you touch me.
I only want to comfort you, to try and help you.
You're the one who needs help. And if you don't get help soon, I swear I'll leave you. I can't live like this anymore.
Morning, sunshine.
What do you want now, Justin?
I hope you don't think that I only drop by here to see you when I want something.
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot how sensitive you are. Is that a cash request you have there?
Yes.
On blue paper, my, means you're asking for over $100,000.
Is there anything you don't know?
Well, I told you, I made the rounds of all the departments at World Oil, and accounting was one of them. It bored me to death, but I did learn a few things.
Well, then you know that I need Ryan Connor's signature on this request, or otherwise accounting will not issue me a check.
He's not here right now. He's at the hospital visiting his uncle. But he should be back shortly.
I'll wait.
I hope you have a good reason for asking for all that money, Justin. Ryan Connor will never sign for it.
Don't worry, honey. I know how to handle Ryan.
Have you found anything out yet?
No, nothing yet.
I think I slept about 2 minutes last night.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Where's Jim?
He went down to the Maritime Union to see if they had a Skip Michaels registered with him.
Damn, we're gonna let it be.
Now take it easy, Billy Joe. We'll find her.
Why would you walk off with some stranger like that?
Yeah, well, if it is that Skip Michaels, he's not exactly a stranger.
It's not like that. I mean, she just met up at the chicken coop. It's not like she knew anything about him. Elaine is not that irresponsible. You know that. She's a pro, man. She had a show coming up. I'm telling you, man, she wouldn't have walked off and left me like that.
Where's the key, Elena?
I already told you, Joe. I don't have it.
Yeah, well, I know different.
Why won't you leave me? Why won't you just let me go?
I told you, you don't go until I have that key.
No, but I don't know anything about any key. Don't you believe me? Please. Please, leave me alone.
Elena. My boss is getting in this morning. He's not as nice as I am. In fact, he can be pretty mean. So I suggest that you just tell me now and save us all a lot of trouble.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
You can't leave me, Jenny.
You can't live like this anymore. Never knowing whether you're going to get in one of your moods or torn on Steve or me.
You gave me cause to be angry last night. I mean, thinking that I'd locked you in the cellar.
You never did deny it, did you, Barry? You slapped me in the face and stormed out of the house.
How could you think I'd do such a thing?
At first, I was ashamed of thinking that to myself. But the survey maps, finding that flashlight down in the cellar, and before you left, all this talk about strawberry preserves and how much you thought about them when you were in the prison camp, it all added up. Are you that jealous of Ryan? Is that it? Are you so afraid of my meeting Ryan that you have to lock me in a cellar?
You did meet him. I did see you together.
I met Ryan in a public place to ask his help for you. I have told you that over and over again. If I were having an affair with this man, you think I'd meet him at the top of the World Club? How can I convince you that Ryan is no longer in my life? I married you.
You regret that decision now, though, don't you?
At the moment, I regret not having forced you to get help sooner. Barrett, I know the hell you've been going through.
No. You couldn't ever understand all of that.
All right. But I've tried to understand. And I've tried to understand what you're going through now. I can't live like this. And neither can you. You've got to go to someone to get help, to get counseling.
I am not going to see a shrink if that's what you're talking about. There's nothing wrong with me. There's nothing a little love and comfort and support from my family can't heal.
I have tried, but it's not enough. You don't trust me. And now, I'm not sure I can trust you. You've got to get outside help, Barrett, before it's too late.
I've never asked strangers for help. And I'm not about to start now. We'll work this out together. Ourselves. You're just making it harder on yourself. We're gonna find out sooner or later.
No, there is nothing to find out. Not for me.
I don't believe you, Elena. No, where's the key?
I don't know. I told you. I don't know anything about a key. Please. Please, let me go.
All you gotta do is tell me where you put it. Then you can go. I'm warning you, Elena! You better tell me where it is! Until my boss gets here, because he's not gonna be real happy when he finds out you haven't told us anything! Because that's not what old Bernie said.
Bernie?
Sure. You remember Bernie, don't you? Of course you do. You found him hanging dead in your closet.
How did you know Bernie?
Oh, old Bernie got around. In fact, he got around a little too much for his own good.
What do you mean?
I mean, your friend Bernie tried to outsmart us. So he had to be taught a lesson. Now, you don't want to end up like Bernie, do you?
I wish if you want to make phone calls, you'd go to your own office to do it. As you can see, I'm trying to get some work done. And quit leaning on my desk.
You know something, I have, something that would cure that lousy mood of yours. How about a nice cup of tea? It'll make your day.
What would make my day is to be able to get my work done.
If somebody calls me, I will be back later.
Listen, Justin, I don't want people coming in.
I want to see Ryan Connery.
Oh, good morning, Max.
I'm sorry Mr. Connery's not in.
When is he going to be in?
Well, he'll be back shortly. Can I help you with anything?
Is there anything that I can help you with, Max?
I have here a geologic survey report done on the Harper land, done in 1955. There's no oil there. I thought Ryan might like to know that world oil is wasting its time and its money.
The survey doesn't prove a thing.
What the survey proves is you got a better chance of finding ice water in hell than you do finding oil on the Harper land.
If you'll excuse me.
All their survey indicates is that there may not be any oil out there.
Well, that's why you take surveys. To make sure you're not wasting your time and your money.
Bubba Wadsworth has a survey which indicates that there is oil on the land.
Yeah, I bet he did. The same way someone makes a house that's fallen down look real good. They paint up the outside real pretty, so nobody'll notice that there's a rotten foundation.
On surveys, it's a matter of opinion.
Only Bubba Wadsworth's opinion's gonna get you some money, right?
The only way anybody's gonna find out for sure, Max, is if they go out there and take a chance and drill. Alex Wheeler has committed $250,000 to this project, and it's going full steam ahead. Whether you like it or not.
Hi, Grandma.
Oh, join me for a cup of coffee?
No, thanks. I've had my fill for the morning. Is Ginny upstairs?
No, she went out for a walk.
Did she eat any breakfast?
Little. Don't think she wanted much. That's a nasty bruise she's got on her cheek.
At least the swelling's down from last night. The ice pack I fixed for her seemed to help.
You know, I read somewhere that more accidents happen in the home than on the highways.
Well, we're part of those statistics now.
Yeah, I guess we are.
Grandma, what was the name of that island that we used to go to in the summer when we were kids?
Fisher Island.
I was thinking, it might be nice to take Ginny and Steve there for a couple of weeks when school's out and before the baby comes. What do you think?
Well, I think that'd be fine. Vacation would do all of you a lot of good.
That's the way I feel. Fresh outlook.
And you don't need to worry about the place. Max and I'll take care of the ranch.
Speaking of Max, I'm getting a little worried about him. He can't talk about anything but Justin putting up oil rigs on the Harper property.
Well, if a forest of oil rigs was going to ruin my view of the range, I'd get upset too.
Wish there was some way that I could help him.
Well, the only man that can help him is Alex Wheeler, and he's in the hospital, struggling for his life.
Ryan Connor running the company now.
Yeah. Same way he did when Alex was in the hospital before.
Wonder if he'd listen to reason. That is, unless he's got some stake in Justin's project.
Well, Ryan doesn't agree with this whole thing any more than Max does.
Are you sure of that, Grandma?
Yes, I am. Somehow Justin got hold of Alex Wheeler and talked him into going along with him. Poor man was probably already sick by then. Anyway, Ryan's hands are tied.
Good. I wonder if, being a good company man, Ryan intends to supervise the whole project, come out and oversee the equipment installation, the drilling.
No, I think Justin and Bubba Wadsworth will take care of that.
I'll give Justin a perfect excuse to see Rena from time to time.
Does that bother Max?
Well, I suppose it must. I wouldn't want any old boyfriend hanging around with Ginny.
Now, Max has no more cause to worry about Rena than you do about Ginny.
I'm not worried about Ginny. But I do resent my brother destroying the land out this way. Supposing it doesn't stop at the Harper place. Supposing in a couple of years we're surrounded by oil rigs.
Doubt if it'll go that far.
Maybe I'll give Ryan a call. See if there isn't some way I can persuade him to stop to it.
Ginny. Ginny, what's wrong? Ginny, tell me what's wrong. I'm so ashamed, Rena. I accused Barrett of locking me in the cellar. Oh, honey. I threw the whole thing about the survey maps and the flashlight that I found down there and how he practically forced me to go down there.
How did he react to it?
He hit me.
Why?
Oh, Jimmy. Oh, honey.
I didn't know that Barrett could be that violent. The man I'm living with is not the Barrett Marshall I know.
Rena, I begged him to go get help, but he won't hear of it. I don't know what to do. I don't know where to turn.
Has he done anything to Steve?
No, not yet. But I'm terrified that he might. I don't know. Maybe I'm all wrong about everything in the cellar and everything else.
Jeb doesn't think you're wrong. You talked to Jeb? Before he went to New York, he had a talk with Ryan Connor, and he asked him to keep an eye on you. Ryan didn't want to make matters worse by coming out here and calling you, so he asked me to check up on you from time to time.
What's happening to us? What have I done to Barrett?
Honey, you haven't done anything. As a matter of fact, you have a lot more patience than I would have had. I would have left him a long time ago.
I thought about leaving him last night. I don't think that's the answer.
What are you waiting for? Until he beats you up again? Until he hurts little Stevie? Ginny! If Barrett can't help himself, there's nothing you can do. But leave him, Ginny, and if I were you, I'd leave him today.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Nothing, right? Do you really think calling up all those hospitals is going to turn up anything?
I don't know, but we got to try.
Well, you don't think Elena's hurt, do you?
I don't know, Billy Joe. I hate to even think about it. You know, hoping that she is in the hospital so I know she's safe and hoping nothing happened to her so she winds up in the hospital. But we got to check every angle.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I just wish Jeb had called from the Maritime Union.
Well, maybe he's just getting a lot of information for us.
Yeah, either that or he's tied up in a lot of red tape. Yeah, maybe that's Jeb now. Hello. Oh, Anita. Hi, yeah, he's here. Yeah. No, everything's fine. I'll put him on. Don't say anything to her about Elena. I don't think there's anything she can do about it, and it'll just make her upset.
All right. Hi there, Sugar Bumps. Well, sure, everything's fine. Just fine. Everything's going great. Oh, yeah, sure, last night just went fantastic. Uh-huh. Well, no, there weren't any reviews in the paper today, no. Well, how about down there? Anything in the Houston papers? Well, you know, I figured they might, you know, she might have just taken something. Well, you know, sometimes they lift stories from the wire service. Yeah. Nothing, huh? Yeah. Well, I just guess next time that I'm back there, I'm going to have to get Elena a publicity agent. That's all. Elena? Yeah, she's fine. She's just real fine. No, Anita, she can't come to the phone now. She slept in today. You know how superstars are, huh? Well, sure. Well, yeah, she was real happy. Ricky made it there in plenty of time to catch the show and everything. Uh-huh. Sure. Look, honey, I gotta go now. I gotta get off the line because I gotta get to some business agents. Yeah, I set up some appointments. Sure, I'll call you back later, okay? Yeah, honey, I love you too. I sure do miss you. Yeah. Oh, sure. No, nothing's wrong. Everything's fine. I'm positive. Bye, darling. Sure wish it was true. Sure wish everything was fine.
Where's the girl?
Next cabin.
Did you have any trouble with her?
Not really. What do you mean, not really?
Anybody see you leave there with her?
Some musician standing by the door. The guy was so high on something, he didn't know where he was. Well, we don't pay any attention to us.
Well, I hope you're right.
Besides, if anybody did see us, you got no way of tracking me down here.
I suppose so. She tell you anything yet?
Not yet.
You think she, you still think she knows where that key is?
The last thing that Bernie said was Elena's name.
Well, just because he said her name doesn't mean he told her where the key is.
Look, I went through that trailer from top to bottom. It wasn't there.
Maybe he hid it someplace else.
Look, with Bernie, I don't think that's the case. Seeing as he knew that we were on to him, he wouldn't just hide it someplace without telling somebody.
Maybe he gave it to another friend.
Bernie didn't have any other friends. I mean, everybody except Elena avoided him like the plague. Now, I know the Decker girl's got it. She knows where it is. I'd stake my life on it.
Then why won't she admit it?
Would you want to give up $500,000?
I got this report from Elroy Jackson, and I figure Elroy's got more credibility than Bubba Wadsworth. I also figure that Ryan Connor's gonna change his mind about your deal once he sees this report.
Ryan isn't calling the shots on this. Alex Wheeler has supported me, and I'm gonna follow through on it.
Even if it means wasting $250,000?
I'm not gonna waste $250,000.
Because you think that I'm just gonna give in and let you drill. I mean, that's the real plan, isn't it? You think I'm gonna get so sick and tired of seeing oil rigs all over the Harper land that I'm just gonna say, okay, Justin, come on in and drill in my land.
You'd do well to do just that. You'd make yourself a bundle of money and you'd have a very, very happy wife.
Now you leave Rena out of this.
She's got just as much a stake in this as you. Oh, buddy.
Now Rena understands how I feel about this.
I don't think anybody understands how you feel, Max, least of all Rena.
Kate and Barrett,
feel the same way that I do.
Yeah, well, I forgot about them.
Now, if Ryan doesn't stop you, I will.
It's pretty big talk for a cattle rancher.
Oh, it's not just talk, Justin. I'm warning you. Now, you cross me, and you regret the day you ever met me.
I'm beginning to regret that day already, Max.
Now, I'm calling your bluff, Justin. I'm not giving in. If you want to stay in the oil business, that's just fine. But you drill someplace else. Because if you drill on the Harper land, that's going to be the last thing you ever do.
Jenny, does Kate know how violent Barry can be?
I haven't said anything to her.
I wonder if she's figured it out herself, but just hasn't said anything to anybody.
I don't know.
Why don't you tell her about it? She may be the one who can get him to a doctor faster than anybody. He's her grandson. She's a tough lady. She won't take no for an answer.
Kate is more against outsiders' help than Barrett is.
Jenny, if he had a heart problem or a broken leg, wouldn't you take him to a doctor?
Rita, we're talking about mental problems.
But that's still a problem that can be treated. Oh, honey, there's nothing to be ashamed of. Oh, I've got a ton of friends who go to shrinks twice a week and talk about it openly.
Well, Kate and Barrett never would.
You think that maybe Courtney might be able to help them?
I can give that a try. I'll talk to Courtney.
You know, if you left him, that might be the quickest way of getting him to a doctor.
I brought this whole thing on myself, Rena, by not being honest with Barrett. I didn't tell him that I was engaged to be married to Ryan. I didn't tell him that I'm carrying Ryan's baby. I have to find a way to help him.
Jenny, if a man locks you up in a cellar, he has got to be crazy. Now, don't kid yourself into believing that you're guilty and that he's going to be destroyed if you leave him. There is absolutely no reason for you to feel guilty in trying to protect yourself and Steve. Now, that's just good common sense.
I have to give him one more chance.
Honey, are you sure that's what you want to do?
Yes.
You going back to the house now?
I'm going over to Buddy and Wanda's. They called earlier and I said I'd stop by.
Okay. Let me know if there's anything I can do, okay?
I will, Rita.
You know, if you want Max and I to take Steve for a while, we'd be happy to do that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, honey. We'll be okay. Good morning, Mr. Connor.
Hi, Ashley. I hope these messages aren't urgent, are they?
Oh, I don't think so. How is Mr. Wheeler?
It's about the same.
You know, I went to the hospital last night. I saw Mrs. Wheeler.
Yes, Iris told me. I was very happy to see her.
I just wish she would go home and get some rest. You know, staying at that hospital night after night is really wearing her out.
Well, she's not going to leave until Alex shows some improvement.
Yeah. Did you see Mr. Wheeler?
Yeah, he didn't recognize me.
So sorry. Oh, I almost forgot. The meeting with the men from the London office has been put off until tomorrow.
Well, that's the first good news I've heard all day. Sure wasn't in the mood to have to deal with them.
Now, I can't wait, though, to hear the latest on Prince Charles and Lady Diana.
Mr. Connor's office. Hello, may I speak to Ryan, please?
May I ask who's calling?
Ashley, this is Rena Decker.
Oh, I hadn't spoken to you in so long. How are things out at the farm? It's very important that I talk to Ryan. Is he there?
Just a moment. Mr. Connor, it's Rena Decker.
Rena.
Hi, Ryan. Can you come out to the ranch?
What is it?
Well, I saw Ginny this morning, and I think there's a problem.
What happened?
I don't want to talk about it over the phone, all right?
I'll be out there as soon as I can. I'll be out of the office for the next few hours, all right?
Well, is there a number you can be reached?
Yeah, Rena Decker's number's in my book.
What are you going to do with that?
What does it look like? We can never be too careful.
Please don't do that.
You're getting a little visit from the boss.
I won't look.
Yeah, I'm just going to make sure of that.
I'll turn around and I'll close my eyes and I'll do anything. Please don't put that on me.
I got my orders. Now, you gonna be a good little girl? Am I gonna have to get rough?
Understand you're being rather uncooperative.
Who are you?
It doesn't matter who I am. All that matters is that you tell me what I want to know.
Please, I already told you. I don't know anything about any key. Bernie never said anything to me about any key. He never gave me a key.
Old Joe here doesn't think you're telling the truth. And as a matter of fact, neither do I.
But I am. I am. You've got to believe me. If I knew where that key was, I would tell you. I would.
That's the same line she keeps giving me.
Oh, please. Please let me take off the blindfold. It scares me.
Want to have to hurt you, Elena. Would we, Joe?
Oh, no. She's too pretty to hurt.
Please, please. I already told you everything I know.
Not everything, Elena. You're holding
up. No, I'm not. I told Joe everything I know.
I don't believe you.
You've got to believe me. Maybe if you would tell me what the key is for, then maybe I would know. Maybe I could help you.
You know what it's for.
No, I don't. I don't. I swear I don't.
You do know. And we're not going to fall for any of these little games. Elena. Sweetheart. We have ways of making you talk.
Hello. Jeb, we're beginning to wonder what happened to you. How are things going down there at the Maritime Unit? Did you find anything out?
Yeah, I was afraid of that.
Look, this guy, he's not registered with him. Well, wouldn't he have shipped out of New York? Did you talk to any of the guys down there? Yeah. Well, it's worth a try. It's the only lead we got. Okay, we're in Chinatown. All right, let me get a paper and a pencil. Okay, hang on. Okay, go ahead. All right. Yeah. Okay, I'll meet you down there. Bye.
Well, what'd he say?
Well, he checked the register for Skip Michaels. There was nobody registered by that name. So then he talked to some of the guys down there.
Yeah?
And there was this one guy who remembered a Skip. Now, he used to live in Chinatown. The guy couldn't remember his last name, but he remembered the tattoo from the description that Jeb gave him.
Is that where you're going now?
Yeah, I'm going to meet him at a restaurant down in Chinatown.
Okay, let's go.
Wait, I think you should stay here.
Man, I'm gonna go crazy if I gotta stay here another minute by myself doing nothing.
If somebody doesn't stay here, how's Elena gonna call? What if she wants to come back? And we don't even know if this lead in Chinatown is gonna pan out.
Okay, okay, I'll stay, but keep in touch, okay?
All right, I will.
And call me just as soon as you find out anything.
Hey, the blindfold off.
Yeah, she's a lot calmer now.
Well, we don't want to frighten her too much.
No, if we do, she might clam up for good.
Well, she hasn't been much good to us so far.
What do you think?
I don't know. She's a lot tougher than I thought she'd be, but it's the only thing we have.
But she's got to break sooner or later. Want to have another go at it?
No, no. Let's let her think about it for a while, and I have a few ideas.
Well, what's the problem? Where's Jenny?
She's up at the Coles. Ryan, I think Barrett is getting out of hand.
What happened?
He slapped Jenny last night.
Is she all right?
She has a little bruise on her cheek.
Why did he slap her?
He got upset. He lost his temper.
Well, that's no reason.
I know that, and you know that.
Look. Did Jenny say what she was going to do about it?
I tried talking to her. I tried to get her to leave Barrett, but she wants to give him another chance. Maybe you can talk some sense into her.
No, I can't go down to the ranch. So no telling how Barrett might react.
You don't have to go to the ranch. I asked Jenny to stop here on her way home.
What made Barrett so mad that he knocked Jenny around?
This time he only slapped her once. There's no telling what he might do the next time. Ryan, I know this is none of my business, but I'm worried about Jenny. He told me to call you.
Right, you did the right thing, Rena. But what was Barrett so mad about?
I think that that's something that Jenny should tell you.
Was it about me?
I don't suppose it started out that way at first, but I wouldn't be surprised if your name was mentioned.
I never thought Barrett go this far that it actually hurt her.
I don't think he meant to.
Yeah, but he did, didn't he? I'm sorry. What do you know about all this?
About you and Jenny?
Yeah.
I know that she still loves you. But she married Barrett because she felt a responsibility to him and to Steve.
I know.
I also know she's carrying your baby. You know, I guessed it a long time ago. Jenny and I talked once, and I asked her about it. She knew that I wouldn't tell anyone, and I haven't. Not even Max.
Where is Max?
He's out at the corral. He's breaking in some new horses. He thought that Barrett might be with him, but he's not sure about that.
Hello, Jenny.
Boy, that Max Decker sure does have a temper, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, too bad Rena hasn't been able to rid him of that trait.
Oh, on the contrary. I found it fascinating. I mean, here all this time, I thought he was just another quiet, good-looking cowboy. But now, maybe Rena knew what she was doing after all.
Despite your romantic fantasies, Ashley, I don't think that marriage is going to last much longer. Especially since Max refuses to be the millionaire that Rena wants. Might I add, Rena deserves.
Are you still planning on going ahead with your project out on the Harbor Lane?
You bet I am, baby. I'm not going to back out now.
Well, I just thought after all those threats that Max Decker made today, you were probably reconsidering.
Oh, Max was mad. He was blowing off steam. All cowboys do that now and then.
Sounded like he meant every single word of it to me.
How do you know what he said? I mean, you were out of the room when he really started to get going.
Remember, I don't have to be present. when conversations are going on. I made a tape of your little argument. I thought you might want to keep it in a safe place for future reference.
You're always working, aren't you?
Oh, you bet I am.
You just let me know when Ryan gets back, will you?
Mr. Connor's office.
I'd like to speak to Ryan Connor, please.
I'm sorry, he's not in. May I ask who's calling?
It's Barrett Marshall.
Oh, well, may I take a message, Mr. Marshall?
It's rather important. Can he be reached anywhere?
Wait, you know, as a matter of fact, he's out your way right now at Rena Decker's. Now, you might give him a call there.
Thank you.
Oh, hi, Dad.
Where are you rushing off to, son?
Oh, I have to pack my pajamas and my toothbrush, because Mom said I could sleep over at Buddy's. Is that all right?
Sure. When you get up to the Colemans, tell your mother...
Rena called Mom, and she went up to the cabin.
Ginny, I'm the one who called Ronnie. Now, I didn't tell you about it on the telephone, because I was afraid you wouldn't come here.
You're right. I've got to go.
Now, calm down. There's no problem.
Chaperone, and I'll be in the room over there. Rena's your friend, just trying to help you.
I know that. I'm just afraid she'll make matters worse.
From what I understand, things are pretty bad right now, aren't they? Anybody do this to you, huh?
He didn't know what he was doing. He's sick.
But what about the next time and the time after that?
There won't be a next time, Ryan.
Why was Barrett so mad at you?
I accused him of locking me in the cellar.
You know, Jeb doesn't think that Barrett really went on that trip to Laredo.
Ryan, I don't know that.
Yes,
for
you
sure.
Do. You do. What was Barrett trying to prove? I mean, that he could hold on to you forever, even if he just locked you in a cellar?
I don't know.
Look, I want you to tell Barrett that you're carrying my baby, not his, and I want you to tell him that you're leaving. Don't worry. I'll stand by you and Steve, and I'll protect you, and I'm going to love you.
Shh. Please. Please listen to me. I can't leave Barrett now.
Have to, because he's really going to hurt you.
I called Courtney, and I'm going over tomorrow to have a long talk with her when I have a checkup, because I think that Courtney might be able to help Barrett get some professional help.
Yeah, well, I really don't think Barrett's going to agree to that.
Well, maybe not, but I've got to try. I've come this far, Ryan. I can't give up now.
Jenny, he's bullied you. He's followed you around town. Now he's abused you.
How much? Please let me handle this my own way without any interference. And then if it doesn't...
I'm so worried about you. I'm afraid for you.
I promise. I'll take care of myself and Steve. I won't let anything happen.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
Thanks.
take it your lack of appetite has nothing to do with the food.
I'm worried.
About what?
About Jamie.
Jamie is going to be all right. He's a grown man. He's going to get over what's happened.
Russ told me that he thinks Jamie is having a problem with prescription drugs.
Because of us?
No, I don't think it's because of us. It's because of everything. It's his job. It's creating too much pressure that he can't handle, and I'm sure that Cecilia's contributing, and on top of all of it, it's Mac, with his incredible insensitivity to what's going on in front of his very eyes.
Don't get wound up.
I can't help getting wound up, Mitch. This is my son we're talking about.
No, I understand that. I appreciate that. I sympathize with that.
But what?
But we've got a son of our own to think about.
Welcome to the Big Apple, Mr. Scott. Did you have a nice flight?
Hey, there's no need for you to come to New York, Mr. Scott.
No.
Oh, Eddie and I could have found him.
Brilliant. Your results have been just brilliant so far.
Got a bit of bad luck.
And they came real close, Mr. Scott.
Close. But no brass ring. You know, you may have come closer than you think. I'll leave that to your imaginations as to what I refer to. You have imaginations, don't you?
Yes, Mr. Scott.
Well, we know what they look like.
Yeah. A very powerful description. I bet you're a couple of poets. Now, you take those pictures, and you hit every clinic, every doctor's office, and every pharmacy in the area. You show those pictures, and you find them.
That could take some time.
It better not.
Well, it's a big town.
You use your head for more than a hat rack. And you said they left most of their money in that hotel room. They can't have gotten far. They're probably within a 20-block radius. And you better find them.
And now, the continuing story of Another World.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to worry you. We should be grateful for what we've got.
I wonder.
You wonder?
Sometimes I get the feeling that you're off in some fantasy. It's got nothing to do with who you are, or what you are, or where we are in the world.
Well, thanks a lot.
I didn't mean that to be harsh.
Yeah, well, you did a pretty good job if you didn't mean it. What brought all this up?
You're a grown woman. You've got children. And I can just see what's going to happen unless you start making some plans and you start making them now.
Well, I'm planning to have a life with you.
Well, that's what I'm trying to get at. I'm talking about a life. Not some sort of dream. I mean, I'd just like to see you in a position where you're not reacting, but you can make some plans and make some real plans for a real life.
So, just what am I supposed to be planning right now?
There are two children. They're going to have to be supported. I'm going to be there. I want to pull it off.
I don't expect you to do that.
I want to do it. I want to do it because I want to do it. But right now, I've got to tell you, it's tenuous.
I don't expect you to do that. I just said that. I've been doing a lot of thinking. I think I'm going to open an art gallery or something.